He is a Swiss Canadian, has a Dutch name, and could perhaps be compared to a Mozart of helicopters. You guessed well. This is Bernd van Doornick, the pilot that represented a real phenomenon in our country. In almost 50 years, he accumulated over 24,000 flight hours and survived many incidents. Bernd retired in November 2007 and moved to Yukon in Canada, where he owns a house. We were lucky enough to follow him in his very last missions.
This is Canada, British Columbia, Montreal, Toronto, Alaska, and Yukon. We will go there. Whitehorse is there, and this is Alaska. These are pictures of Yukon, where we bought a house 2 years ago. This is the house, and this is Lise Marie, my wife. And this is the place in Yukon. It was my dream to become a pilot. I tried to enroll in the Swiss Air Force but failed. So moved to Canada when I was 21 and got my Canadian license in Toronto 6 months later. I flew for 3 or 4 years in Quebec, then moved to the Canadian Rocky Mountains in Yukon and British Columbia. I flew for 4 years in the Rocky Mountains, then came back to Switzerland with 5,000 hours. I spent my holidays in the valley and found a job in an Upper Valaison company. For 16 years, I flew for Air Zermatt until 1992 and worked for another 16 years with Air-Glaciers. I spent 32 years in the valley. That's good. He is the best.
Le meilleur.
It's coffee time now. That's all. We have a 30-minute break. I've been flying for 47 years, of which 40 has solely been on helicopters. That's a long time in which I flew 24,000 hours in total. I achieved 400,000 rotations carrying goods and 6,000 doing mountain rescues. It was nothing special. Fern was blowing at 80 kilometers an hour, and we had to drop two workers on a slope. It was successful and wasn't easy, but everything turned out fine. Bernd. Bernd, he is a friend. I've known him for 25 years. He's a great example. I cannot recognize myself in him, but I do try and do what he did.
J'aurais envie de pas dire de me reconnaître ou d'essayer de faire la même chose que lui, mais il a une bonne ligne, il a une très très bonne.
He gave very good guidance throughout his career. He's very inspiring for young pilots, and I will try and take him and his heritage as this example. When I was small, I said helicopter before I could say mum. I'm still small, I'm just 1.7 meters tall, which makes people laugh. I started flying gliders at 15, fixed wing at 17, then helicopters at 19, in Switzerland. I then moved to Canada, where I passed both my helicopter and fixed wing professional license. I see him as somebody we'll never see again in my generation. It's not possible anymore. We can't fly as much as before. We are limited to 900 hours each year. There is a 1,200-hour limit in Canada, and I've met pilots with 20 or 25,000 hours there, if it still exists there. What he achieved in our mountain environment is exceptional, that's true. But we all have other colleagues, Tony, Siggy, Joe, Jean-Louis, Pepette. They all have 10 or 12,000 hours. It has the same value as Bernd's 24,000 hours, in my opinion.
Incroyable, ce type-là.
I don't know if it's the case with all mountain pilots, but all of my colleagues are very passionate people. They are humble when you get to know them. They are the pleasure of life.
Ouais, le plaisir de vivre, le plaisir de vivre.
Indian summer in Canada.
Indian summer in Canada. With all the colours. I'm 63 and the tree is perhaps 15 years old. I don't know, in fact. That's it, a rainbow. It's a bit like Switzerland. There are many lakes, many mountains. This is my dad's car, 24 years old. And it's still in a good state. This is beautiful, very beautiful. We will go to see this and spend a few years there. I was invited to do an air show at Raron 25 years ago. I have done displays for 25 years and 101 displays, and the last one was at Baie. It's freestyle, nothing special.
But do you train before?
Not at all. It's in my blood. I'm used to it.
toujours mis la barbe.
I've always put on a fake beard and a little hat and a tie.
Air show at Raron.
This was at an air show at Raron with the barrels.
Même chose à Raron.
The same thing at Raron. And another picture when I'm doing a loop with the llama. But I won't tell you where and when. This is my big secret. That's all.
His showman personality brought a kind of showcase with his displays. It's a showcase about flying skills and the capabilities that helicopters offer.
Memories? What kind of memories do you want? A good or a bad story? It's up to you. For example, I had 4 engine failures. They were bad experiences. The engine stopped 4 times. I had an incident 20 years ago at Balteralp. I touched the arm of a crane with the blades. I was lucky enough to land on a small road to the left. It was a rough landing. The stabilizer incident happened at Oberalp Gletscher 26 years ago. I dropped the skis and I was returning to Morel. The horizontal stabilizer detached and hit the tail rotor. It destroyed it. The machine did 2 complete spins to the left. I don't know how, but I suddenly shut off the turbo shaft and tried to land. Everything happened within 12 seconds.
His emergency procedure was perfect. It saved his life. Luck was with him that day. The helicopter wasn't destroyed, he wasn't hurt, and everything was fine.
I've heard of 3 similar incidents in the past. Nobody survived them. I was lucky once again. I did 3 transportations of concrete and the blades were just a meter from the cables. 1 meter, no more. It's normal, nothing special. I just had to be cautious. Business as usual. There was no wind, good weather and no sun. Hence, good conditions. No problem. Two days after my last flight with the llama, I went to church to pray for my deceased colleagues. I've lost 38 friends in Canada and Switzerland in 40 years. In church, I asked God 3 times, why did you let me live throughout my 47-year career? I think everybody has a destiny. Everybody lives their own life. There are people who aren't so lucky, and there are those who have lots of luck. Fortunately, I belong to the second category.
Ja, super gsi. Merci, gell.
Doch ja, merci.
Schönen Tag gsi. Merci.
Thank you, Mr. Flight Assistant.
Assistant de vol. Ciao, gell. Merci. Merci. Merci.
Let's go. That's all for today. I never regret my career. Everything has been fine throughout. I would do exactly the same now. In the same manner, despite the risks. Aviation and helicopters were in my blood. I would do exactly the same if I had to start again. I really liked Switzerland, but I wanted to change my life a little bit, with my wife and see other things. Life goes on, but it's time to stop now. I'm 63. Yeah, it's time to stop.
Lisa and Bernd are in their headquarters in Whitehorse now. They sent us some pictures of their 5,000-kilometre trip to Vancouver. We are looking forward to seeing you next time. In the meantime, remember to fly safe. See you soon. I'm going to go to the hospital.